Hello there, my YouTube gang. What's up? It's Johnnyversity. Again. So tell me, what is it about the Young Turks? You do one video, and a minute later, they make you do a follow-up. Okay, so just before we begin, read a disclaimer thingy, and we'll start with a little appetizer. I'm waiting. So, I promised you an appetizer. Let's go.
And there have been protests that the world does not cover at that wall, and they have not been violent. They would go in and they would sing at the wall. Some people even played violin at the wall.
Now, don't worry, I'll get back to the
giant wall
later on. And on the way, expose Mr. Sankey Turd while he's misquoting a news article and knowingly lies to his viewers. But for now, after you saw Sankey establishing the fact that Palestinians are peace-loving hippies, it's time for him to establish the fact that Israelis are war-mongering Neanderthals. Let's see.
There is an Israeli by the name of Kobi Zavili, and he recently created a Facebook page that urges Benjamin Netanyahu to avoid attacking Iran until after Madonna has a performance in Tel Aviv.
I love that.
Stop your stupid laughing, it makes you look like a whore.
Like, I love the fact that people are still excited about Madonna. Is anyone excited about Madonna in the United States?
We were dancing to that, if we were at all, many decades
ago.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
Like, in the beginning, you're doing the setup, and I'm like, all right, somebody in Israel doesn't want to attack Iran. That's fantastic. Right.
Oh, you're probably talking about those war-mongering criminal nation of Israeli Jews, 65% of which said that they would rather have both Israel and Iran without nuclear weapons. The same poll, by the way, showed that Israelis are split 50-50, with 43% for attacking Iran and 41% against attacking Iran, which is an even split when you consider the 4.4 percentage margin error. Speaking of errors, the same poll showed that Obama had 54% approval rating. What the fuck? But you know what? Why deal with accuracies? I say we just paint them all Israelis as bloodthirsty Madonna fans. What do you say?
All right, voice of reason and for peace and negotiated settlements. Say, no, that's okay. Just bomb them after Madonna.
I'm telling you, man, those hook-nosed Zionists are out of control. They just want to kill, and listen to Madonna, while, of course, they refuse to
negotiate a settlement.
Then again, while 77% of Palestinians said that justice is the destruction of the state of Israel, 76% of Israelis said that justice is the establishment of the state of Palestine. And I now give the stage to the honest journalist, Sankey Turd. Let's go.
Israeli envoy Yitzhak Malcho just told his Palestinian counterpart, Israel wants to keep East Jerusalem and all the land that is on their side of the separation barrier. At least they're a little bit more clear about it now, about their intentions, which we suspected all along.
Well, look what I found. It's the article Sankey Turd is quoting. And now pay attention to the minor differences between Sankey Turd's version and what is actually written. So two Palestinian officials said something based on their interpretation of what they say Israel said. But wait, it gets better. So, Those two Palestinians said that someone said to a third-party Palestinian that told them, and of course they said it anonymously. Now, when asked, an Israeli official said it's bullshit. Not only that, the deputy prime minister of Israel, who actually supports that notion, said he doesn't know what they're talking about. Not as clear-cut as Senki Turd would have you believe, huh? But the most important thing that Senki Turd left out was what was down at the bottom of that article. Because down there at the bottom, we see why those two Palestinians said that a Palestinian said that Israel said. You see, it turns out that Abu Mazen is trying to stop the negotiations while Israel is trying to maintain them. Damn those Madonna-listening, warmongering Israelis. Pah!
When Israel was doing their separation barrier in the West Bank, they said, well, it's just going to be temporary. Don't worry, but this is not part of the negotiations. We're not trying to do a land grab, because they were actually taking 10% of the West Bank and putting it on Israel's side of the separation barrier, this giant wall, right?
No, wrong. Well, you know what? You probably mean this
giant wall,
right? No, that's the
giant wall
in Cyprus. You know, the one that divides the southern part from the unlawfully occupied northern part, occupied by Turkey. But you know what? Let's go to the real apartheid
giant wall,
which spans a dazzling 61 kilometers, which is only less than 10% than the entire planned 708 kilometers fence, out of which around 70% is already built, and the rest is pending approval by the Israeli government and courts. Now, that less than 10% of that
giant wall,
which is actually a
giant wall,
is there not because warmongering Israelis looked for the best way to make Palestinians miserable. It's actually there because of physics. You see, when you put a bulletproof concrete wall between a sniper on the high ground and a low target, let's say a school bus, well, guess what? The sniper cannot shoot at the bus, which would mean that at least some of the 40% of Israeli fatalities due to gunfire would be spared. Now, you're probably asking, what about those 58% fatalities due to suicide bombing? Well, that's where the rest of the 90% of the fence gets into play. And whether you like it or not, those numbers speak for themselves. And the great thing about it is, the less Israeli casualties, the less Israeli reaction. And the less Israeli reaction, the less human shield Palestinians dead due to their own leaders. Now, yes, I know a temporarily suffering Palestinian is worth more than a permanently dead Israeli. But for some reason, Israelis think differently.
I mean, look, 10% of the West Bank is one thing, and it's disastrous. It cuts off so many Palestinian towns, sometimes right in the middle of the village.
Now, this may come as a shock to you, but when the route was drawn, the 1967 border wasn't the concern. Because if you look at the numbers, you'll see that the entire idea was to leave enough distance between the origins of suicide bombers and big Israeli cities, leaving the army enough time to intercept suicide bombers when the electronic sensors of the fence go off. Now, by the way, besides the numerous crossings in the separation barrier, where the cabinet decided that the suffering of Palestinians did not measure up to the security needs, the fence was dismantled and the route replanned. And not only that, but three times the Israeli Supreme Court changed the route of the fence when Palestinians sued the Israeli government and the IDF. Now let's see if you can number the time Israeli Jews sued Arab countries in Arab courts due to the lands that were taken from them during the Great Expulsion of the 50s, where around 800,000 Jews were displaced by force from Arab countries. And like always, my beloved YouTube gang, peace, love, harmony. Have a good one, people. I love you all. Though I don't really like Sankey Turd anymore. Bye-bye.
Fail.